selection has begun in a lawsuit against AEG, the concert promoter for Michael Jackson's comeback tour. His mother, Katherine, is suing the company over her son's death in 2009. Eyewitness News reporter Miriam Hernandez is live in downtown L.A., where potential jurors began filling out questionnaires today. Miriam.
That's right. 70 potential jurors were called in this morning. A large portion asked to be dismissed. That's because they say that serving on a jury so long would create a hardship in their lives. The trial is expected to last 90 court days. Despite all that, this case promises intrigue as well as fireworks.
In the days and weeks before the King of Pop filmed these scenes, there were deals between Michael Jackson, the concert promoter AEG, and Dr. Conrad Murray, the cardiologist hired as Jackson's personal physician. Now, 2 years after Murray was convicted of causing Jackson's death, it is entertainment giant AEG that is on the defense. A jury, which today is in the first stages of the selection process, will examine the deals between the parties and decide whether AEG is liable, whether the corporation should pay Jackson's mother and children as much as $40 billion for the loss of their loved one. Outside the courthouse, the media invasion is underway from camera crews to fans with blogs.
I have about 50,000 followers on various pages on Facebook and hardcore Michael Jackson fans about 40,000 on Twitter.
Unlike the criminal case, the Jackson's lawsuit is expected to get personal. The juror questionnaire asks about drug dependency, whether people can choose to stop if they want to. Barry Edwards, a veteran civil litigator, says it will get ugly.
They're going to be taking Michael Jackson's life and basically dragging it through the dirt of the dark side.
Court filings show AEG blaming Jackson for his own poor health, while the Jackson plaintiffs accuse AEG of pushing Jackson too hard in their drive for profits.
Were they looking out for Michael Jackson's well-being in protecting him by giving him an opportunity for this comeback? Or are they really looking at what they could benefit for themselves?
A pressing issue argued today, a request to allow a camera in the courtroom from media organizations, big and small.
Let us see what is happening in the courtroom. Let us all see.
Again, many jurors were excused today. This process will continue until the court has 100 jurors who can serve, and then they will continue to winnow down until they have 12 people on the panel who can serve as jurors. This process could take 2 to 2.5 weeks. Reporting live from downtown Los Angeles, Miriam Hernandez, ABC7 Eyewitness News.
Thank you, Miriam.